Hey everybody, it's Margaret, and I'm a bit late coming on today. Normally, I go live around 1 o'clock for my weekly goals, and this year I'm focusing on, talking a little bit more about the, anxiety or isolation or depression or things that come along with being self-employed and being, working for yourself. Those type of things that can kind of arise that I think a lot of people don't necessarily talk about. And so I have stuff for that to talk about today. And we'll talk about, weekly goals, how things have been going in my reselling world and then in just life in general. Let me mute that for 1 second. I am going live. I normally do. So if you are in the chat, let me know if everything looks and sounds okay. It looks kind of choppy on my end, and I couldn't find my earbuds. So hopefully everything looks and sounds all right over there. So hello, Kelly and Fran and Carol. Hello. Thank you so much for coming and checking out the video today. So I guess I'll get started. You guys, if you watched last week, I was out at my sister's place. She lives out in the country in Kerrville, and it's really very isolated. You're literally, it takes about 20 minutes to get into town, out in the country. Every time I go there, it's almost like hitting a reset button, because it's really reflective. One, I'm not home amongst all of this stuff or all of my, problems at home that I need to do this, I need to do that. So things really slow down. And then my sister's place, her home, is just really peaceful. Like she doesn't have a lot of clutter. Everything is, in its place, and it smells really good, so it's just really soothing to be there. And then, you're outside. It's just, you're outside. You can see for miles, and just it's wonderful, So, it was really a reflective weekend for me. The boys got to play. They didn't spend any time playing video games, and so anyway, it was just really nice. So as I felt myself starting to relax while I was there, I started asking myself, what's keeping me from having this feeling all the time? Why do I have to come all the way to my sister's place to feel like this? What are the things that are eating away at me, nagging at me, keeping me from being in this mental state at home, because that would be awesome just to be home and have that mental state, right? And maybe it's just part of getting away. I don't know. Before I jump into the rest of that, I'm going to say hello in the chat real fast. So hello, Felicia from Colorado and Fabulous Style. Hello, latest Grace and Rob and Grand Entry Wares. Hello. Hi, Kathy. Hello. Okay. So, and again, apologies. I do get comments almost every time I go live later. Someone who watches doesn't like that I talk to the people in the chat. And again, apologies. And this is kind of part of what I'll talk about a little bit. I go live because it's easy for me, one, and it doesn't take as much work for me to edit. And two, because part of the whole reason is the interaction for me, so I can talk to people as well, because otherwise, I'm just talking to the camera. And I am doing some more videos that are not live, but it really is easier for me. So I hope you'll understand, and apologies. So here we go. So I have my notes down here I'm gonna look at. So yeah, I was really, really reflecting about why I get, so peaceful. And it's every time I go out there. It's just I feel so peaceful, everything's so nice and slow, out in the country. And you just go out, have your coffee, your tea. I don't, she's got a big patio that, balcony, whatever, wraps around the her house. So you can see the view of the hill country all the way around her house. She's up in on the top of the hill, so you can just see all the 360 around the wildlife. It's just amazing. Hearing the kids play, and yeah. So I just started thinking, I'm spread way too thin at home. And I think that's what really gets to me a lot. I feel like I do a lot of things, but I don't do a lot of things really well. So Hey, Mary Lou. Hey, Fabulous Style. Oh, hey, Mike Treasure Gnome. You just had a birthday. Happy birthday, bro. Yeah, that feeling of feeling like everything is spread so thin. I clean my house, but it's just sort of like skimming the surface. And I take care of the boys, that gets done. Okay. But like my businesses, there's a little bit of eBay, a little bit of Etsy. Merch I definitely do more of because it's fun and easy. So just feeling like that, not diving deep into taking care of things, as you can see from the piles behind me. So I started reevaluating, like, okay, well then what's the most important thing for me? So the most important thing was, my boys and my home, because when I go to my sister's place, I feel so peaceful. So I want my home to feel that way. So I said, okay, when I go home, I am going to simplify my life. I'm gonna make sure, number one, that my health is taken care of. So yeah, I'm gonna continue my exercise, workout, and all of that. Two, my boys and my family, make sure they're taken care of and that they never feel like they're having to compete with me, or the compete with a computer, compete with my work. So, making sure that they always know that they're number one. And then after that, my home, organizing, decluttering, just because, yeah, most of the stuff in here is my work stuff. But even in the house, it's like, how many pencils and pens do we need? How many, drawers that I have tape? I'm like, I hoard office supplies, or why are there hammers and wrenches and stuff in the hall closet? Why haven't they made their way back out to the, you know what I mean? It's just like little things like that just kind of like, they just pile up, So I said, that's it. I am going to take it room by room, and we're just, it's going to take a while, but I need that. And it's going to come into this room too, where I ordered all of these supplies from the post office because you can get all these priority boxes and things. So I have buku boxes, and now eBay, then eBay started doing their thing. Well, I don't ship that many big things anymore. So I have got a giant, my hall closet, my other hall closet out here is full, literally full of priority boxes. So I'm just thinking, I'm gonna go through, take the ones that, maybe take one or two of the sizes that I don't use very often just to have on hand just in case. And I'm gonna take the rest up to the post office, where they have that shipping area there, and just leave it for people. Other people who could really use it. So just doing those kinds of things to get things cleared out and to make my life easier. I mean, and you open my pantry and it's just, we have those reusable bags and they're just falling all over the place. I mean, it's just madness, So just that's it. It's time to get things where, where we can find them. Where's that cord? I can't find that cord, Have it all organized. I used to be so good about it, but yeah, not so much anymore. So those were some of the things that were bothering me. Let me say hey in the chat again. Oh yes, I will tell Kathy says, tell Randy and Tom happy birthday. Well, it's Randy, my husband, his birthday tomorrow. He's a twin, so Randy and his twin Tom have a birthday tomorrow, and they will be 40 something, a year younger than me, so I won't tell you. Hey, Thrifting Life. Hello, Mary Lou. Oh, she says, I need to declutter. Yes. This is it. Thrifting Life says, my bedroom is the dumping ground for our house. Working on it today. Mary Lou says, I took extra UPS supplies, but USPS supplies back to the PO. Yes. Hey, Joni. So that's going on. And then my boys' rooms are an explosion. So that's another thing that just has to happen. And I have these boxes that when we went dumpster diving, they're really nice Barnes and Noble boxes. So what I think I'm going to do is, label a couple with the boys' names, pile in the stuff from their rooms, and just kind of tuck them in the back of my closet for a while and see if they don't notice, one of those type of things. So we'll see. We'll see. I mean, and then we have board games coming out our ears, but we play them, so I won't get rid of those because we do family game night usually once a week. It's been a we did it last night, but yeah. So anyway, so that's part of it. So I was sitting there, okay, and so I'm at my sister's place. Hey, Treasure Pirate, go check out Treasure Pirate's channel too. Oh, we've got lots of friends in here that have channels, by the way. So go hover over people's names and go follow everybody. Hey, Chili. So as I'm at my sister's place, I'm also thinking, okay, what other ways, what else is like nagging at my life, making me feel like, just little stresses that are just like hanging in there, like nagging at you, or my mom calls it the squirrels, things that just keep you up, or things that make it where you can't fall asleep at night because you're like, there's little stresses running around in your head. So, I just said, okay, hang on, I lost my place right now. I'm spread too thin, and unfortunately, Facebook is a place where you friend lots of people, and then suddenly you realize you've got some toxic people in your life. So that was another thing. Like there were things that were happening in my personal life that were like I just had to take stock of my friends, and I'm one of those people that I would rather have two or three really close friends that I trust 100% that we're just amazing friends, and just say that's it. I don't want to stress about things like that. So I just wanted to say, okay, I'm done with feeling like I've got toxic people in my life, and so that was tough too. But at the same time, very invigorating and refreshing to feel like, okay, that's done. That I don't. That's done. So that was, it was something to think about, but it was also something I won't have to worry about anymore, if that makes sense. Let's see. Vintage made, my craft fabric patterns are out of control. Well, at least those are smalls, right? I mean, that's something that we'll talk about in a second with my business model, where I'm definitely going back to smalls. And yeah, I'm definitely going back to smalls. Okay, so yeah, so going out to my sister's really, makes me slow down, because when I am at home, it's just like go, 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 go. And I don't have time to stop and reflect, because it's just going all the time, So if you're watching this later or in the chat right now, leave me a comment and let me know something that you do to help you from becoming spread too thin, because I have a feeling that a lot of us have this in our lives. A lot of us, that work for ourselves. I mean, I would wake up first thing in the morning and work until I went to bed at night. I mean, and a lot of people say, I don't know how you do everything you do, Margaret. Well, I don't watch TV. I mean, sometimes I'll watch like a little bit while I'm eating lunch. I don't watch TV. I mean, I want to start sewing with my mom, but like, I don't have any. Yeah. If it's not, I'm doing something with the boys, I'm working, I'm, listing, photographing, it's just always something, boom, 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 all the time, So let me know what you do to kind of try to keep yourself from being spread too thin, because I'm sure we could all use some tips, Let's see in the chat what people are saying. Chili says, I understand. I don't have friends. It's just me and my husband. Kids are grown. I only talk positive thinking. Yeah. Treasure Pirate, watching from the UK, having a large evening roasty dinner. Yum. Kathy says, I'm spread too thin with everything that we have going on. Yeah, that's just, I need to stop, because a couple weeks ago I just kind of cracked. I just, you can only go so long, and then like crack. Friend says, I learned how to say no. Not so easy. Just saying, that's done. Yeah. Frazzled Dad, you got a great name. Frazzled Dad says, every day I reorder my list to the fastest path to cash. There you go. Saying no is a great skill, and you can't do everything. This is true. Okay, so on the reverse, one of the problems I had was not actually talking to some of my friends as much as I should, or planning, because almost all of my good friends have young children or have a lot of children. And so, homeschooling, some of them do homeschooling or have a baby. And so just making sure that those friends that are really good friends, that you cultivate those friendships so they don't feel like Margaret has forgotten me, or, and it probably goes both ways, they're probably thinking the same thing. Oh, I need to call Margaret or whatever. So just taking that few minutes to make that phone call or say, hey, let's go get coffee. So, I mean, that's something, my friend AJ and I went out walking. She just called me last night and was like, hey, let's go walk. So I'm like, Randy, I'm out. I'm going to walk with AJ over here, and then my friend Dawn and I going to get coffee tonight, just because I haven't seen her in like a year. But yeah, because she's a homeschooling mom, and she's hustling like I am. So it's just, yeah, nice. So trying to make sure that you cultivate those positive friendships and just really take care of yourself, because that can do a lot for you mentally, you know. Let's see. Joni says, no is a complete sentence, right? Kelly says, hey girl, how was your trip yesterday? It was really good. So we had our reseller meetup yesterday. I was going to talk about it later, but hey, I have a group on Facebook called Gulf Coast Resellers, and we've had a few meetups, and we met up yesterday, and it was really good. It was on the far north side of town, which is not my stomping ground at all, but I wanted to, the first time we were over here, I was kind of on my side, then we, you know, I wanted to go somewhere on the other side. Hang on, baby. Sorry. And so I felt kind of bad because I'm like, I don't know when these places open. I've never been, you know. And then there were not a ton of scores. Let's just, some people found some things and some of the people didn't find anything. So, it was really good. You know, everybody got to hang out and talk and we had lunch. And actually the next meetup is already scheduled. So if you're in the Houston area or in the area that you think you might want to come hang out, you know, go check us out on Facebook. It's Gulf Coast Resellers. We'd love to have you. And I'm actually planning some other things. And I was actually talking to, I'm trying to remember everybody's names. Debbie. No, that's not it. Anyway, I was talking to another lady who's got a meetup group in our area and trying to, I think we might be combining forces to bring more people in and do stuff more frequently. So I'm kind of excited about that. Only I'm really bad with names, so I'm sure I said your name wrong. Yep. Okay, let me say hey in the chat. Kelly says, sorry for making you jump around. No problem. No, I would do it on my own. Chili says, you know, if you don't take care of yourself, you will break. Take a day off for you. Yes, this is true. Vintage May, try to limit work no more than 8 hours. Leave my time in the day for rest. Yes. How old are my boys? My boys are 6 and 9. 6 and 9. Okay, I don't know who's calling me, but okay. So I am scrolling through. Yvonne says, do you use Meetup or just organize through your Facebook group? It's called Gulf Coast Resellers. And then in that group, we schedule meetups in there. So that way, people are, I don't know, where we go, I don't know, yeah. Just keeps it more organized. I accidentally created it in like where everybody could see it. And I was like, nobody's going to want, you know, like, yeah, anyway. So go check it out. Latest Grace, I try to identify things that are priority and must get done and do those first. Yes, that's a good tip. That's another thing I've been trying to do is in the evening, getting out my schedule, my calendar, and saying, okay, what are the things that are happening tomorrow? What are the things I need to make sure get done? Which sounds silly, like make dinner, you know? But sometimes I get so busy that when it's like 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and I'm like, oh yeah, I forgot. What am I making for dinner tonight? So those roast chickens from the store are godsend sometimes. Kelly says, my daughter is 33. Yeah, yeah, and spending time with my boys is really important for me. My son's school, my older son's school, just started a chess club, and I'm so excited about it. He was really excited too, and it's like Friday morning before school, and the guy running it was like, do you know, parents, if you can be there to help, because they had like 80 kids sign up. It's awesome. So I was like, yes, I'm so excited because that is exactly why I started staying home. So I could be at those things for my children. So that was very awesome. Let's see. I'm going to say your name wrong. Dolder. I'm sure I'm saying it wrong. McClain, prioritize is the key for me. I'm a single mom with two. I had to realize that I can't do everything. Some things have to go. This is true. Yeah, very true. Judy asked, do I do all my listings myself or do I have someone to help me? It's all me. It's all me. And I consider myself a part-timer. You know, the money that I make helps our family. We've actually come to rely on it. I first started just to have a little extra money for me, but now we've gotten used to having that bit of an extra income for the cushion and for just, you know, if the kids want to take a summer camp or, you know, after school programs and things like that, that's where my money comes into it. Hey, Danny's mom. Hi. Wendy. And thrifting life. I meal plan on Sundays and use a whiteboard on my fridge for weeks' menus. It helps a lot. And you know, when I do that, it really helps. And then I forget to do it, you know? Kelly says, do you know chess? I bought marble pieces and I don't know how to list them, Margaret. Yeah, I mean, I know chess. Generally, you would have, I mean, you could do replacement parts for chess sets, I guess. But okay, so looking back at my notes down here. Okay, so as far as I'm kind of sticking to that being spread too thin theme, because that's after my reflective weekend at my sister's. So as you may know, I'm pulling out of Amazon FBA. I haven't recalled everything yet. I think February 15th was the date, and then everything needs to, you know, that's when they're going to assess those long-term storage fees. So I'm trying to get everything out by then. But I went through and dropped a lot of prices to see if I could get some of it moved so I wouldn't have to have it, you know, pay for the shipping it back to me. And I've already gotten quite a bit back, a lot of boxes, speaking of more clutter. So now it's just a matter of figuring out what I'm going to do with that. I know somebody mentioned to me they might be interested in some of the stuff. You know, they could get it for a deal and I could send it to them and they can do what they want to do because, yeah. So I'm focusing on eBay and Etsy and then merch, of course. And I will keep doing YouTube because that's, you know, it's done a lot for me, so I'm gonna keep doing it. Let's see. Oh, okay. Dolder McLean was explaining their name. Okay. Yes. Oh, she says, or he says, your videos make me feel not so alone. Thank you. I agree. Doing them live makes me feel not so alone. And so I know, and I feel people when they say, oh, you know, you're doing another live video and we don't know who you're talking to and we can't see the chat. Apologies for that, but it really is helpful for me too, so to see and talk to people. So hey, Reverend Michelle Jones Holden, hello. Okay, hey Gina, how's it going? All right, so those are my spreading too thin as far as my platforms. As far as my workroom, as you can see, I've been working on media, but this pile has been here for how long? So the bits that I've been taking pictures of, I have a tub down here on the floor that I'm putting it into as I'm done, but I am already feeling like I don't want to list it. So yeah, I just don't. So I think that's something else I need to go through and look at. Like, what's the profit for me? I know I picked these CDs up for like a dime or a quarter or something at a garage sale. Is it going to be worth my time and effort to go ahead and list them, or what? You know, maybe I just need to put them in a box and have a garage sale myself and just say that, you know, I'm done. I mean, same thing with I have a ton of games over here that I was planning on sending into Amazon, and I just may need to say, you know, redonate or check and see how much the profit really is. If it's not over a certain amount, I just need to cut it and send it in, you know, take something. Mary Lou says, I will buy those CDs from you. Send me a message, texasgaltreasures@gmail.com, and we'll work out a deal. Because, yeah, I mean, yeah, I've got a ton of cassettes too. And I know they can do okay. And, you know, you could lot them up and, but, yeah. She says, Grand Entry Wares, I take them to Half Price Books. And I did take a big basket of stuff to Half Price Books. Big basket. And it was like 15 bucks. So let's see. Somebody's talking about walk-in picker. Let me see what's going on. Doop-a-doo. Is walk-in picker looking for donations? I haven't heard that. I need to go check it out. Miriam says, I feel like that about some stuff. Is this worth listing? Yeah, so I think I need to definitely look into seeing, is it worth listing? Joni says, I sent donation stuff to Chris because I was not going to be able to get. Oh, okay. So are you guys sending stuff for Chris to list on his eBay net? Because I know he has to walk everywhere. That's a good idea. I mean, because I have plenty of stuff. So yeah, maybe we can work a deal in the games. Sure thing. Send me a, uh-oh, I clicked something. Hang on. Send me a message, you know, if you're interested in things I'm talking about, because we'll make a deal. They always say it could help him in winter. Okay, yeah. Okay, well, I'll get Chris is a great guy. So I'll get his email or his address, because goodness knows I've got tons I can send to him. And then I'll feel like I'm helping a friend, and a friend is helping me. It's a win-win, right? So yeah, let me know if there was something I was talking about you're interested in. And Joni says I filled a flat rate padded envelope full of patterns. She said, "Oh, that's a good idea." All right. All right, Chris. You may be getting more than you bargained for. Okay, I'm not sure. That's true, because he's in Colorado, and in wintertime he probably doesn't get out to walk as much to pick stuff up. All right. I never thought of that. Thanks, guys. All right, so going down in my chat. Do do do. All right. So the next thing I was talking about was getting my YouTube schedule back on track. I used to be pretty good about having a set schedule about like what kind of videos went out on certain days. Like Mondays was sales, and Tuesday was usually like a tutorial. Wednesday would be a merch. Thursday, I'm doing a lot of interviews lately, so those might end up being on Thursdays. It depends, because I like to work with whoever's schedule, whoever it is that I'm going to interview. I like to work with their schedule. So generally that's Thursday. You know, Friday's a haul video. Saturday is, I can't remember everything now. So, and then Sunday would be, you know, the how's it going this week kind of video. So so I'm trying to get that back on track so everybody knows what to expect. So if you're like, okay, Wednesday is unboxings, maybe that's what Thursday was. I don't know. I just kind of put unboxings wherever, because, and that's usually when I'll have like maybe two a day, because not everybody watches the unboxings. So yeah, I enjoy doing them though, so I'm gonna keep doing them. Kelly says, I'm supposed to be listing, but you're worth it. Thanks so much. Alrighty. So yeah, trying to get my YouTube schedule back on track is a biggie. I think will help me with my, just personally help me with my schedule. And then as far as updates go, Mary Lou says, do you announce when you're about to do a live video? I always miss them. Usually I'll post on my Facebook page, which is Texas Gal Treasures. I didn't today because I was already late. So generally, but usually on Sundays it's 1 o'clock. It's usually around lunchtime, most, you know, 12, 1 if I go live. Just kind of depends, between noon and 2, generally in that window. But yeah, if I usually post to Facebook, and I think there's some way to get an alert. So well, yeah. Okay, so updates. Merch is going well. You know, I'm at the 500 tier, and I'm able to upload 3 a day, so I'm super grateful for that. I'm trying to make sure, you know, I have so far got my 3 a day going. You know, some people that we know have 20 or 40 that they can upload a day, which would be challenging, you know, but there are so many people that don't have theirs opened up at all, or they're not even in yet. So I really want to make sure I'm taking advantage of everything I can. Kathy says, if you click the bell, you will know when she's on. Okay, is there like a bell? All right, maybe it'll send you a little alert. Awesome. Yes. So, and then eBay and Etsy are going pretty well. I've been taking a lot of pictures to try to have them ready when I can list, you know, and I have to do that. Sometimes it's in the evenings after the kids go to bed, or just trying to squeeze in time for listings when I can. I mean, Friday I was out all day. I mean, I left the house at 7:15. I came home for lunch. I was home for about 30 minutes, and then I was gone again until almost 5 o'clock. So I didn't get anything listed. It was just crazy all over the place. YouTube's doing really well. I'm just updates again. Over that 8,000 mark, pushing towards 9,000. And I really enjoyed doing the jewelry jar giveaway. So I think at 9,000, I'll do like a jewelry bag where I pick and choose pieces like I did at 7,000, and then do another jar at 10,000. Yeah. So tell your friends, come over and subscribe. And then the updates for Chatterbooks. That's the book club that I run. I have a Facebook group called Chatterbooks, and then I have a separate YouTube channel for that, where it's an online book club. So I'm thinking that it's going to have to start being maybe every other month. So we would end up having six for the year instead of 12. I want to do more, but realistically, it's hard because I'm in three book clubs. So it's really hard for me to get all the books read. And then, so that's just one more thing. So that was one of those things, like, what else is just kind of eating away with me at me? Like, I can't get this done. I can't get this down. It's just bothering me. So I think that's one of the things that I'm gonna have to just kind of spread it out. I love it. I love reading, and it's one of the things that kind of motivates me to keep reading, knowing that I'm going to have, be at book club for the library, be at book club with my girls, be at book club chatterbooks. So just doing that. Joni says, and you're wondering why you're stretched too thin, right? Yeah, Kelly says that will take so much stress off you. Yes, I agree. Okay, so there's that. And then, hey, Purple Lily. And then International League of Thrifters is going really well too, our group. So if you haven't joined International League of Thrifters, we are a Facebook group, reselling group, where we have challenges and we have Pinterest parties to help promote each other's listings. We share YouTube videos, we share all kinds of info. The Jewelry Lovers and Sellers group has grown tremendously. Also a place where we, talk about jewelry and help each other out. So go over and join if you're, interested in jewelry, or you're thinking of selling jewelry, or you just want to learn more. So those are going really great. I actually have another lady in that group that I'm going to ask about helping moderate, because it's grown that much. I mean, we're getting close to 1,000 members in the Jewelry Lovers group. My lot is 4,000 something or other. And we're talking about getting another admin as well to kind of help. I mean, things run pretty smoothly, but every now and then there's like a hiccup that happens. But yeah, we've got a pretty good system going there with the admins in the group. So, but I think we're going to look at a couple other people. Kelly says, I'm on a found listings challenge, but I didn't know what to do to join. Basically, the listing challenge, what was it? This week, Andrea was doing one about things you're just putting off. So all you have to do is in the comment section, just write, this is what I want to do. Hey, my goal is, so you just have to say what your goal is, and we just kind of cheer each other on. Say, I'm gonna list all this, I'm gonna get all my media photographed and listed, or I want to get all whatever the challenge is. And then everybody just says, hey, how's it going? How's your day? I've got this done. What have you got done? Oh, good job. It's just like kind of like checking in. Let's see. JR Coker says, good afternoon. Can you please touch on how you have your picture taking area set up for good lighting? I can. I can. One moment, please. All right. So, and then I talked earlier about the meetup. So we have the Gulf Coast reseller. So we had our meetup. So if you're in the area, come over and join. I'm gonna copy what you said here so I make sure I don't forget to talk about it. There we go. So yeah, Gulf Coast resellers. And I think, okay, I had a few questions and answers that I was gonna hit on. Okay, so my picture area, I have a small picture area in my room where I'm at right now. If I don't judge, this is the mess we're talking about. So I'm gonna turn it over here so you can see. Like, I have this window here. This is the little light box that I got. Look, this is all the cassettes that I'm working on taking pictures of. And so I can get, again, I'll show you. I can open this blind to get the natural light in. And then I've got this gray thing right here. It's called an Ott light. So it comes in, gets a little more light on the side. And then I've got my big light to come on top. So when I'm doing small things like that, I'll do it in here. But if I need more space, I have a bigger pop-up that I go to my kitchen table in the kitchen. And then I have two windows. So I try to get as much natural light in as I can. And then I have a tall lamp that I get, just turn on all the lights that I can. So that's pretty much what I do for that. If you need a way that you, like, you don't have a tent or something, and you're going for more natural light. If you, there's a channel called The Poetry of Nice. Carly, she's one of the admins in International League of Thrifters. She has an amazing method. So she uses like a poster board, and she kind of curves it onto this chair, and then she has it kind of just angled towards the light, where the natural light is, and takes her pictures that way. And then she has also another video where she talks about using photo fuse to help kind of knock out some of the background a little bit, but still leave some shadows to make it look nice. She's amazing. Her pictures are amazing. So check her out. Carly is the poetry of nice. So if you need a different way, that's another way. Let's see. And as far as jewelry, I just try to, sometimes I have to turn off some of the lights when I'm shooting jewelry to get some of the glare off. And then I brighten it up after the fact. You know, I'll change the exposure a bit to brighten it up. Because that can be a problem. It's a really shiny piece of jewelry. For sure, for sure. Purple Lily says, I have a question. How do you categorize your jewelry after you've listed it? I am having issues with that. So what I do, it's all over there. I don't want to show you. It's such a mess. All right, I'm going to show you. This is real. I'm telling you, it's a mess. This is a mess. If you can see, you're on my laptop. Over there, you see those shoe boxes? There are they. There they are. There's like those shoe boxes, and they have the labels on them. That's how I categorize my jewelry. So, like, there's a sh like one of those plastic shoe boxes says rings. Then there's one that says charms and pendants. There's one that says necklaces, earrings, men's accessories. And I might have to start doing more once I actually start listing more of my jewelry. I've got over here a plastic tub that's full of ones I've taken pictures of. So once that's done, then I take that tub over there and I sort it out into the correct shoebox over there. Kelly says, Margaret, do you want to see my room? Yours is spotless. Mine's a disaster. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I can't even. All right. So I have some questions that came up over the last, you know, I save the questions that people leave on the com under the videos and comments to come back and answer. So TT Chauvery asks, where do you keep your inventory? I keep it here in the room. So you know, I showed you where I have my listed jewelry, and then in this closet I have a lot. Most of the other stuff that's listed is in this closet right here behind me. And this closet has got shelves all in it, so it's just shelf, shelf, shelves. So all of my stuff is in there that's listed. Is that it? There's probably some. There may be some list. I think I have a tub out here with media. That's maybe it's this one. So it's got some listed and some unlisted. Sharky Moms, oh, that's nothing. My mess would make you feel much better. Oh gosh. Judy says, what's your eBay store name? On eBay and Etsy, everywhere. I'm Texas Gal Treasures. So you can find me on Instagram, eBay, Etsy, everywhere. Texas Gal Treasures. So another question that I got. Oh, I chopped off whose name it was. Okay. So somebody asked if I ever counter offer on sales, or do I just accept, like, I guess if I someone sends me a best offer, because I do have, you know, best offer pretty much everything. So a few items I've put, like, I won't accept a best offer below a certain amount. Most items I don't. Because sometimes people want to see what they can get. So like I've had somebody send me a low ball offer. And I try not, you know, I don't take it personally. I don't get let the, try to let the emotions get involved in that. And I just counter offer with what I'm comfortable with. Sometimes I never hear back from them. Sometimes they'll accept it. You know, they just like, let me see if I can get something or if I can, you know what I mean? So I do, you know, I'll just say what I'm comfortable with and go from there. So yeah, they said, I'm curious how you do it because I feel that I would have expected some of mine to have sales, but they were lowballing. Oh, yeah, I mean, and people are going to see what they can get. They just will. So, Treasure Pirate, I have a whole room which is wall-to-wall stock. The whole reason to look into jewelry and save some more space. Yes, that's the thing. Like, once I get some of these, like literally a whole shelf full of games over here, from floor to ceiling. If I got that stuff cleared away, then I could really organize the jewelry. You know, I have, you know, glasses that I'm selling, smaller things, glasses, jewelry, wrapping paper. I'll probably still do mugs and hats and things because there's really good return on investments on those. And then I still have a ton of my grandmother's stuff, you guys. So let's see. Okay, So next, and the next question that I've gotten was from 21st Century Handyman. Have you ever sold items to people when you do live streaming? And I have. When I've done, live streaming of haul videos, and even if it's not live streaming, haul videos or jewelry jar unboxings, a lot of times people will see something they like and then just message me and we make a deal. So and usually I think I'm giving a good, a few times I've said I've given a price and the person has said, that's a little more than I want to spend. But just say something back to me. How about this? How about this price instead? Because I'm really, to me it's like win-win for both of us. So Raz asked, do you sell gold jewelry? I do. I've sold some gold, like I took some to the gold buying, the guy that buys the gold. And then I've sold, like gold rings and things on my eBay, Etsy. So let's see. Oh, weather. They're talking about the weather. Please. Oh, they're expecting to. Yeah, tornadoes are really, really bad. And our winds are bad here. So Kelly, you're in Florida, right? I think. Florida, right? But Randy went out running. The winds are just bananas. He's like sand and like gravel was getting kicked up by the wind into his eyes. So yeah, if you're in one of these areas where the winds are really bad, definitely stay safe. Okay, so here's another question that I've gotten. Penny says, where do you find people that clean out houses and offer to buy what they don't want? So I've run into this twice where people have had garage sales and they've told me they're house cleaner, not the house cleaner, but like a home organizer. And I don't know how to find out. I wish there was a way because I love it because they don't have any emotional attachment. They've got this stuff from somebody else's house that they've cleaned out to help organize, and they're just selling it in a garage sale. And it's just cheap, very inexpensive. So I think it's just a matter of luck, or I guess you could probably Google it or check Craigslist for people that have. I'm guessing they would have to have an ad or word of mouth or ask people, hey, do you know somebody who does this? And try to get in contact with people like that, to find out. I'm, like, hey, I'm interested in buying because I did. I mean, one of the last ones I went to is where I found that 10 karat gold cross with diamonds on it, and that's the one I took to the gold guy last week. And it was 70 bucks. I mean, 10 karat gold isn't this high. You're not going to get a ton of money. And then he was like, the diamonds are, I paid $8. I walked out of there with 70 bucks. I was a happy girl. I would have sold it online if it wasn't damaged, but it was already damaged. And I was like, what am I going to do with this damaged, cross? So, yeah. Nishana says, contact local estate sale companies. They know people. Oh, good idea. That's a good idea. I mean, that's the thing. Like, if you start really thinking about, like, all right, how can we make this happen? Get connected with people for sure. There's ways out there. So yeah. I think we're getting close to the end. I'm done with my questions. If you guys have more questions in the chat, let me know. Also, again, oh, Bryce's Aggie Babe here in Pasadena, they had close to a 100-pound mirror fall from the wall. You're renovating the house. Hey, Bryce, you need to come over and join our Gulf Coast reseller group because our next meetup is going to be going down Spencer. So it'll be right there in your neck of the woods. Yeah, so what was I going to say? Yeah, let me know again in the comment section below what you do to keep yourself from becoming spread too thin. What you do to, like I say, I went to my sister's place and I felt so relaxed. But why can't I have that peace at home? I know meditation, if I took that time, but I just feel like there's no space in my house for that. Like I feel everything is just like closing in on me. So I think it's a matter of getting my space at home to reflect what I want to feel. So, let me know what you guys do to keep yourself from spreading too thin and to find that peace that you get when you go on vacation or go, out in the country and just get away from it all. Because I would love to hear about it so I can share with others and we can find that peace together, y'all. Judy says, I was wondering if you sell your gold jewelry or scrap it. It depends on the piece. I've done both. So I've sold some And I have scrapped some. Depending on the condition of the piece, there were some cufflinks that were nice. And I ended up getting 350, $400 for them, that I did take to him. And he's not gonna scrap them. I think he was gonna sell them on, that I bought for a dollar. So I thought about it, they were such a high price. I was like, I can list these and wait for a really long time for the buyer. And then they could get them and not like them and send them back and have all this return stuff. Or at the moment, I was like, or I could take it to him, because they were 18 karat gold, really heavy. They were super nice. So yeah, I did take them over to the gold guy because I felt like a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush at the moment. And that 350, 375, I can't remember the exact amount that I got. And then I felt like, I used that money. I gave my husband $100 because he never uses money to, he never spends money on himself. And so I was like, here's $100 I want you to, take and do something nice for yourself. We took, and took my parents out to a nice dinner, and it was just like, fine. We had a little bit of money that we could do something. I don't know, it was, yeah, I felt like it was a gift. I found them, it was a gift, and definitely, and now whenever I donate, I definitely donate my things back to this charity shop for sure. We are still live, Melissa. Bryce Aggie Babe, awesome. I should join y'all as long as I'm still in town. You're moving to Florida, so it's back and forth. Oh, okay. You're not gonna escape those hurricanes in Florida. I always say Florida's like the what is it? The lightning rod for the hurricanes for the United States, usually. They hit other places too, but they always hit Florida. It's like, here I am. So good luck. Let's see. La da da. I'm not, okay, this is back and forth talk. Okay, hello, hello. All right, so hit the thumbs up button, you guys. It really does help with ranking in my channel in searches and things when they see there's activity on the channel. So, and if you want, come back later and leave a comment because that's also something that's really nice to do that helps my channel out. And I actually put it there for my mom, but if you're interested, I put my Amazon affiliate link because my mom is always, she buys from Amazon all the time. And she's like, and I ask her, do you use my affiliate link, mom? Because it's like a finder's fee. So it's, you don't pay anything extra. But if you click on the link when you're going to go buy something from Amazon, I tell her, if you click on that, go to Amazon. It tells Amazon, Margaret sent me. And then whatever you buy, you spend, it's normal. What it doesn't cost anymore. But then it's like, Margaret gets a quarter or 20, whatever. So I think like one thing she bought was like $35, and it was like I got $2. So those little things, they start rolling together and adding up so that we can do nice things for our family. So yeah, every little bit helps, as you guys probably know very well. So anyway, yeah, hit the thumbs up button, you guys. Leave me a comment. Do all those wonderful nice things that you can do, and I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks so much for coming today. Bye.